Amen, amen. Thank you, Pastor. What a soul-stirring challenge. Hallelujah. We have been given the word of God today to challenge souls. We will now invite our Reverend Eunice to come and say a covering prayer over our pastor.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, oh Lord, we love you. We love you. We love you. Hallelujah. And we bless your holy name. We are just so grateful unto you, Lord God, for your word. We thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name, even for Pastor Randy and Pastor Seaman, who have, oh my goodness, tag team and has delivered your word so mightily, Lord God, not to puff themselves up, but to point mankind to you. Lord God, you reminded us earlier in the message, Lord God, you said as the serpent was lifted up in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. And then Pastor Randy comes on and he says, and he proves, Lord God, how much you loved us. You loved us so much. You sent your Son so that we can be delivered, so that we can be healed, so that we can be redeemed back unto you. Lord God, I'm praying, Lord, for every hearer that hears your word, every born again person, Lord God, that we will grow and that we will mature, that we will transform, that we will self-examine, Lord God, and see the need, Lord God, that we need to have more of you. And every sinner will take the opportunity, Lord, while they can, before it's too late, and that they will fully surrender themselves unto you. Father God, I pray for this man and this woman of God who has delivered your word so mightily because of the love for mankind, because of obedience unto you. I pray your continued blood covering over them, shield, guide, and continue to protect them. May you continue to meet their every need. In Jesus' name we pray and we give thanks. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. At this time, we will invite our covering pastor, the Reverend Dr. Maria A. Seaman. Let us put our hands together as the woman of God comes. I want to see us put our hands together because we appreciate her, we love her, and we thank God for her. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. God bless you there, Reverend Eunice, and certainly to Pastor Randy Lightborn, God bless you. As one more time, you've delivered quite a thought-provoking sermon. I do greet every one of you, Beacons for Christ Ministry, RIT Stacy, and your first time leading out, I think. God bless you. And certainly to RIT Laquita, DIT, Sister Lachey, everyone, it's good to greet you on really just a precious moment, a precious day, Palm Sunday. And in the name of Jesus, as we think about the sermon, as we think about what's going on, we heard our pastor today preach from the sermon, the proof of how much God loves us. Please repent. Oh boy, isn't that the message? Okay, so we dealt with point one, God really seeks after us real love. To me, the broad term that I want to affix, look at me, baby, she's clapping. The broad term that I want to speak to is relationship. That which was broken, God wants healed. And here's food for thought, that we actually live in a world that because we move further and further away from God, from his word, relationships are just going haywire, left, right, and center. That's what I want to say. I want us to understand that ever since the fall in the Garden of Eden, there has been the drive for relationship. Then by golly gee, in this last 40 years, introducing social media. Okay, instead of having a relationship with the bride, going AWOL, Lone Ranger, all by themselves. So they've lost the connection. It's only through Jesus. That's what I'm saying. And we understand in his word, the drawing power I thought of something funny that I did. So I'm going to share it with you because that's what I do. You know, you talked about Noah and Abram and the drawing power, right? And what I thought of pajama pants and I thought of sweatpants. They have the drawstrings. That's so they can stay up. So your private parts are hidden and you can be acceptable in public. Okay. Ooh, because one of the things that began to happen about 15, 20 years ago, we start seeing the pants hold on, you see? Ain't no relationship. Don't tell me you're a child of God. I'm going to see you. Okay, see how the pastor goes? So we're dealing with this drawing, you know, as I say, point one, Noah, the ark, the relationship. We have to become the ark. We have to house God's presence so people can actually have a relationship with us and then find Jesus himself, right? So I was thinking about the missing sheep. I'm always thinking about that lost sheep. As I reminded someone, I didn't even know who I was talking about. Remember, this is the lost sheep, not the rebellious sheep, not the sheep making a hole through the fence to escape. Because we try, no, you should go running after them. No. Are they lost or are they runaways? You see? Because if not, you have to consider then that our cry for repentance is to the wrong person. So when the one is lost repents, now you're having a party. No, yeah, that's what we want. You mean you're lost? You want to come in? You want the relationship? That's why the angels are rejoicing. The 99 are safe. But the one that was on their way to hell, have repented, have been drawn by the Spirit of God. And now we rejoice over that. You know why pastors rejoice over that? That person becomes an eager witness. Oh, you catch people when they're freshly saved. They think they can save Satan. They think they can save anybody. That's a different type of vibe. You got Christians been there all this time? No, they're professional Christians now. But the passion, I want to stay a fresh Christian. Now, this missing sheep, I want you to think about the missing sheep. That means the missing purpose, missing true value, missing connection. That's why we want them. That's why we preach every Sunday. That's why we teach God's word. If this word will hit that sheep, that's ripe and ready. All right? All about getting back to Eden and then getting back to God. Let's get back to Eden. Yeah. All right. And then always, I saw you there, Reverend Eunice. I'm not even looking. Good peripheral vision. I saw you. Then if we are looking at the father and the prodigal son, that separation, of course, akin to the separation of Jesus on the cross. Separated. No wonder the earth got dark. Stop a minute. Say it again, Seaman. Okay, say it easier. All right. The father and the son were separated. So the earth experienced darkness. Somebody's not getting it. Some people are getting it. I'm going to say it one more time. The father and the son are separated. So the earth experienced a darkness it never has before. Could that be why, ladies and gentlemen? That the earth, the world is so dark. Fathers, go get your sons. Be connected to your son, to your seed now. You can't even say sons, because the girls are going haywire. Until we connect with the light of the world, Jesus Christ, that worm, took on that worm, we're going to talk about that. The world's going to get darker. I am not the preacher that it's all good. It's going to be a great revival. It's going to get hell going to keep on bursting forth on the earth because our minds are evil and wicked. And if you go out, churches that are messed up, well, what can we say? There you go. There you go. Crazy preaching. I better not talk about it. Let me continue on. So Gethsemane, yeah. Ugh. that always gets me, where he had to draw, listen to this now, he had to draw on the relationship that he had. Jesus had to draw on the relationship he had with God, because if he remained in his soul realm, can you imagine the fight? I mean, this is a level. Not only did he know, pay attention, because it's all knowing, right? Not only did he know what he was going to go through, he knew what it was going to feel like. Oh, any Jesus, not now one on this screen, beginning with me. No, thank you. No, thank you. However, he's Jesus, Son of God, Father. Woo. If it be possible, he knows it's not possible, but he wants us to hear it and understand it, that we, big issue right here, big issue in every church, including Shekinah, separate your soul realm from your spirit, man. Let your spirit control that flesh. Crazy people all day long, every church, in every church. I feel, well, if only, well, you should have. I feel like saying, how much all that you spent trying to tell me what to do? How much reading of your Bible you did? How much going into the spirit? No, you're busy. I said one word. I'm not soldiers. Or the petty soldiers. That's my new little word, the petty soldiers. So we have to learn to separate. If you're going to fulfill the will that God has for you, your feelings can't even go in it. Enjoy it when you can, fine. Other than that, you've got orders. Pastor Randy Lightborn, you've got orders, whether you like it or not. You're either going to be working in, that's right, you're either going to be the soldier doing your orders, or you're going to absent without leave. And if you do that, if I do that, when we stand before God, or stand before Jesus initially, and he says, now, remember when you didn't feel like saying that or whatnot? This is the person that was supposed to hear it. So they went straight to hell. And, oh, they had children that, you see the responsibility, the weight? I just can't take it. I don't know why people want to be pastors. I'm telling you the truth right now. Why would you want all that responsibility? It's hard enough raising your own children. It came out of your womb fresh. You got other people's womb children. You see? Yeah. But that's why the grace of God, that's where we have to say, nevertheless. Can't stand you. Want to hear all the man speak, but they want you to speak, though, because the man ain't going to speak. But still can't stand you, because women shouldn't preach. Get on your last nerve. Get on your nerves. I'm telling you, it's about relationship and separating you. You heard me say, get on my last nerve. Quickly separate the soul and the spirit. I'm not going to sit here ever for you or Bermuda and say that some things just don't irritate me. But I have to learn. I'm not going to start a sermon, start preaching, meditate on his word with ill feelings. So you got to get that in check, you see? Because you want people to return to God. And Jesus was wounded for eternity. I'm wounded just for a little bit now. He was wounded for eternity. How about that? Yeah, God permitted his son Jesus to become sin, to take man back to him. Wow. Isn't that wonderful? Then this worm, you know, I could talk about that all day. Wow. The crimson worm, the vermilion. Crimson stain, the stain that it leaves red, and then after a while goes white. 3 days goes white. So representing the 3 days coming through, here's my point. If we accept this work and this example of the worm, the vermilion, the red to the white, that's the witness to our children. We're bloodstained. My sins were black, but I dipped them in the red blood of they were dipped in the red blood of Jesus, and now whiter than snow, whiter than snow. That's what I need people to see in my life. Then I can call for others to repent. You can't call for anybody to repent unless you've gone through yourself. You see? And so the end word I just want to linger on is this phrase, I should say, repent for relationship. Repent for relationship. Repent for relationship. Because for Christ's ministry, I say you continue to be mightily blessed to have a servant of God who studies. See, let me say this. We're so used to steak, sirloin. We're so used to five course top meals. Sometimes we take it for granted. You go listen to some garbage on YouTube at people. Well, gotta start our chats again because it's beyond me what's going on. I'm like, what? Bastardizing the word of God. And got crowds like they won the Super Bowl. Read your word. If not, you'll never know when you're hearing stupidity from a pulpit. Read your word. God bless you. Have a beautiful week. Woo! My favorite week. My favorite week. Victory starting today. Yes, Passion Week. I'm passionate about it. You stay passionate, and you know what I'm saying. Blessings abound.
Come on, everyone. Let's give our covering pastor an applause for those challenging, thought-provoking words. Oh, we got a two-for-one special today. Pastor bringing his word. Pastor Seaman coming right behind. Two-for-one blessings. Hallelujah. Yes, I love that, Pastor Seaman. Repent for relationship. Pastor challenged us that it's all about repentance. So I challenge each of you, as we have now come into agreement, we are going to say amen, because we have heard the word of God that exalts God. It rebukes us. It encourages us. So as we sing, let the church say amen. We desire to A, apply the word. M, meditate on the word. E, embrace the word. And N, nail it to our hearts. Hallelujah. Let us sing. Let the church say amen.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So
let the church
say
amen.
Yeah. Can I get a win?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church.
To what his word
says.
Say. From the healing of your body,
amen.
To the raising of the dead,
amen.
No matter how you're feeling,
amen.
Or how your world is reeling,
amen.
Battle on through the night,
amen.
'Cause you're gonna win the fight,
amen.
Even in the valley,
amen.
Or standing at your Red Sea,
amen.
Continue to say,
amen.
'Cause your help. Let the church say,
oh,
lift your hands wherever you are and let the church. Let the church say.
God has spoken.
Hallelujah.
Let the church
say.
Greetings. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and soon coming King. Our announcements for the week of March 24th are as follows. We have our youth program, Champion Kids for Christ, on Saturday mornings at 10 a.m. and it's led by RIT Stacy. Next Saturday, the children will be learning about the resurrection. Also on Saturdays, we have our Beacons Bible Study, BBS, at 5:30 p.m. There will be no Bible study next Saturday. We will resume on April 6th and will be studying Ephesians chapter 2. On Sunday mornings at 9 a.m., we have our Sunday school class, which is led by Reverend Eunice. Our next class will be on Sunday, April 7th, and we will be covering Genesis chapter 12, God Calls Abram. We are reading from the cover to cover complete Bible. It's daylight saving time again. Our clocks here in the UK will spring forward by 1 hour at 1 a.m. next Sunday, March 31st. Our Sunday evening praise and worship service will begin at 7 p.m. UK time, 3 p.m. Bermuda time, and 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All are welcome to join us. If you have cable in Bermuda, you can catch the replay of our services on Swim TV 24 or on Voice for Our Times YouTube. You can also catch the replay of our sermons on Real Knows Real, Apple, Google, or Spotify podcasts. This week is considered Holy Week to us as children of God. We are invited to Shekinah Worship Center's Good Friday service on March 29th. We in the UK can view the service on Voice for Our Times Facebook page or on YouTube at 12 to 3 p.m. UK time and 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. Bermuda time. Join us on Resurrection Sunday, where Pastor Randy will be ministering from the sermon topic, Reaching Your Resurrected Purpose, sometimes Manasseh. Scripture text, Genesis 41, 46 to 56. Come and receive your blessing. We would also like to take this opportunity to acknowledge a very special work accomplishment for RIT Laquita, who has recently been featured in the Bermuda Reinsurance Magazine on an exclusive work interview, of which we want to wish her a huge congratulations and well done from the Beacons for Christ ministry family. We love to celebrate each other in our success. May God continue to richly bless you. Please feel free to reach out to us on Beacons for Christ Ministry UK at gmail.com or on our mobile +44 795 157 1671. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you. Blessings abound.
Hallelujah. Govern yourselves accordingly, according to the announcements. We will now invite our brother Roger to say our closing prayer.
Amen. What a beautiful and powerful service. I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, and I thank him some more. Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, great God Almighty, what a wonderful honor it is to be in the house again among such great, dedicated, loving people who adore you. Father, it is such a mighty presence. But when it's a message with this type of level, it takes it to a whole different place. I mean, I can't put in words how excited I am, Father, to have received such a enlightening, encouraging word. I thank you for all the wonderful people that you blessed to be here to hear this message. All those who are going to be hearing it in the near future. Father, this is no mistake that we're here. There's no mistake that those who are going to be hearing it, there's a reason for it, and we have to step up to that reason and embrace the gift that it is and move accordingly. And I pray that each and every one of us that takes the goodies from today and applies it, Father, will be moved to new levels and can take it and be a vessel for others in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless each and every one of us as we position ourselves, Father, for the remainder of the day. Those here in the UK might be going down or whatever it is we have to do. Let us marinate on this beautiful word. And we thank you for it, Father. Again and again, I just thank you. And special thanks, Father God, all covering pastors well, who just stepped in and just turned it up just a bit more. And we are so grateful for all of these goodies, Father. None of this, Father, is by accident. It is because you're speaking to us. And we ask that we all move on and we take these goodies into this powerful week ahead. This full authority in that beautiful and mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. We will now proclaim our Beacons for Christ kingdom affirmation. Hold the line. Speak it boldly as we armor up. We are beacons for Christ. Off the beams of our Father, we shine, battling against the spirits of darkness. We hold the line. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, we align, anchored in His strength. We hold the line. Our branches will bear kingdom fruit. We are attached to the holy vine. We remain resolute in kingdom purpose. We hold the line. We take on the great commission to spread the gospel to all mankind, steadfast, unshaken, and kingdom assigned. We are beacons for Christ, and we hold the line. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So this now concludes our service for today, this Palm Sunday 2024. We thank you for worshiping with us. We give thanks to our pastor for again delivering that powerful message, our covering pastor. We thank our SWIM family, our Beacons for Christ family, all of those that will look at this service later on social media. We pray God's blessings on you continuously. And as we go forth, we just want to say, continue to be a light, those that walk in God's light. May you continue to let your light so shine before man that they might see your good works and glorify our Father in heaven. We pray that you will continue to be salt of the earth, salt that doesn't lose its flavor. I pray that you would continue to walk in line with God's alignment and God's will for your life. So we thank you again. Have a blessed week in the Lord. Blessings abound.